Hi everyone, topic for today's presentation is HTML5 semantic elements. Hypertext markup language, it's a standard markup language for web pages and web applications. And the building blocks of HTML pages are HTML elements. Originally, HTML had about like 20 tags and it displayed simple text with the basic markup. Now there are two categories for HTML elements. First is semantic and second is non-semantic elements. First is HTML5 semantic elements. Now semantics, it refers to the study of the meaning of the words and the phrases in any language. Therefore in HTML, semantic elements refers to the elements with a meaning. Second is non-semantic elements. Non-semantic elements, as the name suggests, it refers to the elements with the which don't tell their what's the meaning of the content. And in HTML, example of non-semantic elements are div element, span element. If we see comparison between HTML4 and HTML5 structure, in HTML4 IDs and classes were used to define the structure, whereas in HTML5 direct elements are used. Here in header, ID header is given, whereas in HTML5 direct header tag is given. HTML semantic tags. Now semantic tags clearly define the content, and the elements are header, nav, section, article, aside, footer and many more. The basic mainly used elements are. Why semantic elements? Now semantic elements are basically used to structure the code, and it is it maintains the readability. First one is header element. Header element specifies a header for a document or a web page. For introductory content, we can use header. We can have several header in a web page. Second is footer. Footer specifies a footer for a document or a section. Now we can have several footer elements for a web page. Footer typically contains the information, copyright information, the links to terms and privacy policy and many more. Then we have nav element. Nav element defines the navigation links, and basically it is intended for the major block. Like below the header, we have a complete large block for menu. We can use nav element there. Next is section. Section basically here refers to the thematic grouping of the content, basically typically with a heading. So here in HTML, section defines a section for a document. Like in home page, we can divide it into many sections which contain information regarding the web page. Next is aside. Aside basically refers to the content which is placed aside from the rest of the content. Example of aside is sidebar in a web page. Next is article. Article refers to the self-contained independent content. And in HTML, article should be such that it should be possible to read it independently from the rest of the web page. Example of article is a blog post or a newspaper article. Like in web page, we have a blog post above, just above the footer. So it's basically the highlight for the web page. Thank you.
So what is the advantage of HTML5 over HTML4?
Sir, basically in HTML4, IDs or classes were used to maintain the structure and maintain the readability. But in HTML5, we directly have the tags. Like if we wanna use a header, so we will give directly header tag. But in HTML4, directly IDs were given.
So is that the only difference?
It's the difference, and more is for search engine, it was difficult to search for the different content of a web page like header. But in HTML5, it clearly defined the structure that this is the header for search engine.
Nobody has any other question?
Yeah, one question. In HTML5, we can use several header and footers.
Yeah, we can use several header and footers.
How it can be possible? Like there will be a like multiple header?
Like for a section, we can give a header. There can be many sections in a web page.
Why would you give a section as a header? Header is a completely different. Header is header and footer are...
Yeah, it's completely different, but in case... like there are some pages, there are many pages in a website, so we may require several headers